You're watching the Bear Dice Club.
All right. Welcome to Bad Dice Club, everybody, as we play through Abomination Vaults. How are you doing tonight?
I'm doing well. How about you?
Not let winter kill me.
I mean, I'm trying not to, but I do believe it is supposed to snow again this week.
We're supposed to get, like, 25 inches this week.
It's like the third week for me, my sickness, but it's like I'm like finally saying like, oh, you should go to a doctor. I'm like, yeah, you know what, you might be right, just the longevity of the illness here. So it's like, I don't know, the bacterial viral fungal load is like high enough to cause symptoms but low enough to like me kind of forgetting about it. I go Thursday, so hopefully I'll be 100% next week. But this is week three, so
just we'll let you go.
It likes me. Little organisms like me, I guess.
I went to the Feywild one
because you understand that. You know,
getting a fungal load.
I do understand.
They've connected with you.
It was the sexiest trip I ever took.
In more ways than one. And
starting to feel sexual. my right hand on my bowl, and then my left hand slowly. ... No.
I can pop out everybody's video except for VDO for some reason.
Pop out our video?
I can't pop out like the main video here with all of us on it, because I usually pop it out and then put it on Foundry.
Oh. Why is it doing so that? You like right click it and then click picture in picture?
That didn't work.
What?
Didn't weird. Work.
That's weird. Maybe I just didn't
usually
set it up correctly.
I use Firefox. And Firefox usually, if it has a video feed, it just puts the little button on it. Mine doesn't. Oh well, I guess I'll just live with it today.
Yeah, there's a lot of ways to work around that one.
Fair.
I will just put Justin on here because I can see everything else.
Okay, that works. All right, so let's just jump in. Let's get lots of game time in here today. You guys have been real close to wrapping up this floor already. I'm impressed with how quick you've been flying through it. I think you guys, if you really hit it hard, you could even finish it tonight, possibly. We'll see.
Hooray!
I'm not gonna...
That's a stretch goal, kind of.
That is a stretch goal. I don't think that's going to happen.
Sorts. We shall see.
So
we shall see what our dice look like tonight.
Yes.
We may live up to our namesake and only get a couple rooms in. That's all right. Let's see. Last time you guys, I'm kind of looking at our map here. Oh, yeah, you ventured up to the surface and found a group of kobolds. They said, hey, there's this thing and it wants to eat us. And we don't like that. And it's like, all right, well, we're going to go take care of it. Ended up being a river drake swimming around and looking for its next meal. Guys quickly took care of that. Then you guys met, I believe, was that when you met? Oh, no. I was going to say you met me in Yasmara, but that was before. You met one of the other NPCs of Otari shortly after. You met the Tengu when you're doing some shopping, Magaloy. I think that's how you say it. Magaloy?
Sure.
Magaloy. Conventional English. Magaloy. Got some potions. Did a little drinking. Namiya's not looking too good.
Namiya doesn't need to even walk in here, so.
He's a little stupider today than he was yesterday. And then you made your way down, back down into the vaults. You went through the cavern and found some mold that really didn't feel too good once you got close to it. Stepped into this room, which I'll now put on the map here for everyone to see. And yeah, the bones began moving around and forming up into this
spooky, big, scary skeleton.
Nasty, spooky, scary skeleton. And it's time to roll for initiative. So let's do it. Put you guys in combat mode here.
Okay.
Just roll for Nambia here.
I rolled good.
You did. Natural 16.
Can I roll?
Nambia got a 13.
Crafting.
You probably could.
For my initiative.
Crafting. Tell me more about that.
Yes. I'm going to craft an escape.
Gonna craft an escape. I would say perception, please. Nice try. Thanks for playing.
Okay. Fuck. Well, you weren't too far off there. Sawyer.
I tried.
Cool.
That's right. Maybe I can pull aggro a little bit.
Yeah,
let's
I'll
see what happens. Character. He's a big boy, and you guys are in a little room. So there are some great opportunities for you guys here if you guys are able to pull them off here. We'll see what happens. At this point, the bones are still forming up. So you guys kind of have a chance to see what happens. You guys have to jump on them. So starting off with Soul at the top of initiative.
What's this thing on the bottom right? This is new. Encounter tracker.
What?
That pop That's up. Cool. I did get some different modules because there's one called Monk's Little Details that split off into like three different modules. So I got rid of the one and then got those three.
I actually like this better than the
carousel.
Carousel, yes.
I agree.
Oh, you do?
I would actually use this instead of the carousel. Yeah, because it shows, at least for me, it shows my HP. And I can change my HP in it. And it shows the round number. I know the other one does too if you highlight it, but this one's just there.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Nice. I can always just make this smaller then. Okay. So, my turn.
Yeah, you can collapse the carousel if you want. Boop. There it is.
Okay.
Collapsed. Perfect.
I'm going to use lunge here, and I'm going to attack this boy.
All right. Cool.
This is AC
an extra,
go down because he's
that's
warming.
An extra action. Let me look at his stat sheet here. Probably not.
So I'm using
right.
this
Let me look
place
the journal.
Of a strike.
Okay. It pulls rusty and fights. Nope, nothing about that. We'll say it's harder to hit.
So?
It's more vulnerable, but also harder to hit because the bones are moving and kind of flying all over the place. And
okay.
Flying together, Iron Man style.
23?
23. Whoops. That is a hit, my friend.
Hey, here, I gotta turn up the music and stuff. Okay. So I'll roll damage.
Whee!
And I'm just gonna keep going with these lunges. Yeah. I'm just not gonna move. I'm gonna get all three
keep
attacks and.
Oops.
Stop it. Get out of here.
I miss up our combat music. 19 Sorry about
hit?
That. 19 is a hit. Yep.
I thought I had him selected, but it, like, unselected.
I really messed that up.
All right. That's good hit.
That's another 19 damage.
19 damage. God. All right, let me look at this guy
here. So far, I've done 29 damage.
Just a real solid chunk there.
This is all slashing damage?
This is all slashing damage.
All right, cool.
And then I'll roll one more time with the striking katana.
Dude, I dare you.
I get a plus two. That's a whiff. Okay, and I'm done. That's my turn.
All right, cool.
Hey, Jeb. If you wanted to hit a crit here, I sure would appreciate it.
Oh,
Jeb's been fucking up the last few kind of combats. He hasn't been.
Remember, what I'm saying.
Remember to toggle your sniping duo.
Yeah, I got it. I got it on. Okay. Yep. Thank you. It's getting easier to remember.
Oh, wait a second. Yeah. Half.
Well, it's nice that when you go over to your strikes, it's in there anyways. So.
Exactly. Yeah. Yeah.
Plus, now I have another thing in mind that says, because of this retribution axe, I have another toggle in there, so.
Oh, jeez, yeah.
But the retribution axe doesn't do as much as my striking katana.
Well, it doesn't have the striking on it, right? It's just
yeah. And it doesn't have the deadly D8.
Yeah.
Or the two-handed D10. Really,
it's not really your style, I think, either, right?
It isn't, no. I mean, I'm going to throw this into a... my chest at home, and then if somebody makes a character that's a barbarian or somebody who takes up big, I'm just gonna let them have it.
Add it to your collection for now.
Yeah.
Oh my God, I mean, essentially, I got a few. All right. I got a few.
No.
You remember at the end of last one? At the end of the last.
He's got 30 feet of movement.
Well, I was gonna say at the end of the last session. Mm-hmm. I do very, very much remember yelling back the other way. That is certainly what I plan on doing.
Instincts are clouded.
I do remember that. Yes.
Stupefied always includes a value.
Okay, so you're yelling back the other way. What should Mr. Nambia do?
He could always, yeah.
Well, what would Namiya do? I don't know.
Yeah, it's kind of a tough call.
Let's see.
He does always have the crossbow.
You can always just roll the banana or flip a coin or just do slash R or slash roll DC and heads he goes back and tails he stays in.
Yeah. That's a
like
one.
Back out.
He's backing out then.
Oh.
Yeah, I guess he'll do that.
Yeah, I mean, he doesn't have to like leave the encounter, but
yeah, he's gonna back up a bit.
Can he
though.
Buff people?
I don't think he's much of a buffer.
With knowledge,
he doesn't even. Yeah, he can't even see in there. He doesn't know what's in there.
Yeah, I can't see.
So all he knows is
all he hears is a guy in a top hat.
Wouldn't
yelling,
he be able to like?
Up.
Lean out or something?
He could. He'll five step forward and take a look. Oh, that's a thing. And back up. It could be his movement. Like, oh,
you go this way, I'll go home.
Yeah, exactly.
You go this way, I'll go home.
And okay. Then with that, he's going to do his devised stratagem. Because he's got movement, devise a stratagem. And so now he's got a thing to roll for that. Skills. Oh, what's he got for lore? Undead lore?
Undead lore would probably be a good one here.
That's our natural 15 for a 23. Is that a success? Yep, that is a success.
Nice.
Yeah, I'd say that's...
Is that a critical
no.
Cal?
Well, it depends if I go by the unspecific lore or specific lore. Undead, well, I would say kind of unspecific.
Wait, undead? That is the specific lore that you're looking for here.
Well,
not like
I
he's
mean,
trying
undead,
to do like.
Undead is kind of a big category. You got ghosts, you've got.
Well, they
yeah, don't have stuff.
Yeah, but they don't have like a skill that is.
It's not like he's a necromancer lore. Who's specific lifting lore. Undead, and we don't know. He just is undead. Isn't
I
he?
Think. I think when they mean specific lore, they're talking about whether it be like draconic lore, undead lore, fey lore, that sort of thing.
Define
Pathfinder 2E specific lore.
See, I will die on this hill.
Versus specific lore. Okay. Reddit, what do you got for me? A good rule of thumb is that anything that's a creature family, demon, vampire, golem would be specific, but anything that's a trait encompassing multiple families would be unspecific. Say, fiend lore would be unspecific to demons, devils, daemons, and some others. So, but he does get that full check. So you guys, this is, you faced skeletons before. He's immune to death effects. He's immune to paralyzation, and he does have resistance to a bunch of things, including piercing and slashing damage. And he yells that out at you guys. He also says, he's real big. He can't fit through this door. And that's what he's going to yell at you guys. So.
Okay.
Wow, wow, wow.
All right. I got to come up maybe some fancy, funny one-liner like, over here, bonehead. Something like this. right? It's doubly funny because Jeb's also a bonehead. Yeah.
That's the joke.
Is that a hit?
You rolled a 15?
Yes.
No, that is not.
Okay.
I actually target him when you do that.
I could have sworn
I
weren't
kidding about not being able to hit anything.
I think I just had like my one. I was like a one-hit wonder, a one-combat wonder, and then I'm just all
against Morlocks.
Yeah, yeah, that was my one thing.
Getting old.
Oh shit! Everything hurts. Shit.
Can you?
Ouch, man.
Oh my god.
That's the end of my turn, guys.
All right.
I warned you, Shane. I warned you.
So for this first round, the bones are still coming together, and that's going to be his whole entire round. Is his turn is just putting himself together as quickly as he possibly can.
Okay.
For the skeletal giant. So next up, we have Herman.
Sure, man. Well, shit. I guess I am just going to try and leave the best I can. Mm-hmm. I do not believe I can step away from them because I don't think you can step into an already occupied square.
No. You have to do a full move.
I'm pretty sure this guy's got a 10-foot reach because I think the last guy did too.
Well, he's huge. He's like a meat. Yeah, he's large.
I were to move here,
he's got that glaive or spear.
Could I then, lean over the cover and take a pot shot, and then continue my movement afterwards?
I didn't see any pings. I'm sorry.
So if I moved here,
uh-huh,
like that, could I then like lean back around the corner and take a pot shot, like basically in cover, is what I'm saying?
I think his AC would be a bit higher, just because it's got that hard corner there, and a bunch of people in front of you as well. So if you want to get the clean shot, you'll have to do that before you go through the room there. So you could do it right in front of him. And then get the hell out if you'd like.
Well, then, you know what?
He doesn't swing at you or anything as you
I will try and do that first, then, because I wish to be a team player. And what we could use right now is a team prayer. Oh, Christ. I really hope this doesn't kill me.
Is that your prayer?
Yes, that is my prayer. I will, you know what? I'll even spell strike, I guess. Well, fuck it, I guess. That'll teach me to cry. There we go. 25 feet. But I do have to move back here because tried moving on top of Namiad. That will end my turn.
All right, cool.
But I didn't end up getting skewered or anything.
No, it did not attack you at all.
Okay, well, that's definitely good.
Oh, did you reload though? Or
no, I haven't yet. I used two actions to shoot. And then
oh,
I
do
got
your
the
spell
fuck out.
Thingy. Yeah.
What spell did you use?
I was gonna use grasping claw.
Gouging
claw. There we go. Because I know that the last time we fought one of these, it did not seem to care about electric damage nearly all that much.
Good call.
So I'm going to take a step forward because I'm trying to protect my friendly's retreat here. I know he's got a bit of reach, so I'm trying to just get him not to be able to reach. And I'm going to attack him.
Okay.
That sounds good. 29
that hit. That is a critical hit, my friend.
Yeah, you keep getting I'm totally cool with this. Keep getting these all of the attacks. I'm cool with you.
34 damage.
Okay.
He's still up.
Yeah. Do you want to explain this hit?
Is this a
like
kill?
What do you no, I wouldn't say it's a kill. He's got
if you want to narrate your critical hit.
Yeah, I mean minus.
Well, it's soul. It's all about like technique, right? He just plants his feet firmly, grips his soul. He's holding it two-handed, right? Just grips it firmly and it's just the perfect angle. It looks effortless.
Because
he's been training, man. So it's nothing special. It's nothing glamorous. It's nothing like exciting. It's just what it needs to be.
Okay.
Just very simple.
Soul's not that exciting when it comes to his strikes, but he is very effective. All right. And I'm going to strike again. I got one more attack in me.
There
you go.
Hit?
20
with
hits.
20.
Oh, my damage. Ooh, not great. 7 damage.
7. And with the resistance, it does 2 points of damage.
Yeah.
And so the bones are very, wobbly. And you just kind of see your moment to hit it just where it needs to be hit. And it takes 2 damage, which is the amount of HP that it had remaining, and it falls to the ground.
Like I said, Soul is methodical. So it's... I do what I need to, and I don't exert more energy.
I do appreciate you covering my retreat as I, just...
Well, I figure with a 10-foot reach, he couldn't step forward on top of me, so he couldn't get to Jeb either.
You want some medicine rolls there, Sherman?
Yes.
Okay, I'll just roll
That scared me.
Did this guy just have another glaive on him?
He had a glaive. He was this big rusty glaive that he was reaching for. His hand never quite got there. The hand was about to attach, and then it just fell to the floor. Yeah.
Okay, I'll roll that.
God, I...
Boise. That was...
2 hours worth of healing, 11 health.
You know what's great about souls?
Well, yeah, we gotta get Shane back up to full.
Yeah, he is in rough shape from that thing before.
I got potions. Do you just want a potion, man?
Well, I mean, this way it doesn't cost anything, and that's pretty awesome.
Yeah, I know, but I'm just trying to think of, like...
We don't really have, like, a deadline.
We sit there for... I guess we've been doing that.
Yeah, we don't have a deadline from the mayor or anything.
Yeah,
so...
I'm only missing 4 HP after that, so
okay,
that
I'll
is...
Okay, I'll do one more... One more hour here, because 4 HP has... That amount of HP can make a difference.
Well, actually, how's about you do this one for Namiad? Because apparently he's also injured.
Namiad needs it. Yep.
Okay, so that would be a crit for him.
Of course it is! Only non-combat roles in this house.
Damn right. That's how I...
So he gets healed 18 points.
18 health?
I didn't realize he was that hurt.
Is that all his health?
He doesn't have a lot of HP.
And that would only take up that extra hour.
Oh, yeah, it would have just been in between Shane's treatments, Sherman's treatments.
So you guys spent a total of 2 hours.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. Cool.
It's about 5 p.m. at this point.
I don't know that I'm the best person to lead the group because.
You get a little ahead of yourself. You got a gun. Stay back.
Whoever the first person is gonna kind of be boggled. So
shit. Yeah. So
how long is he stupefied for? What
for like
gets rid
a
of stupefied? Do you need like a? It's like a day. Okay.
If I remember right, it was like a whole ass day, wasn't it?
24 hours. Yeah. Was that the day? Was that yesterday? Guys. Went there? Or is that earlier today?
No, this is the same day. It's the same day.
Drinking.
As much as I'd like to say it isn't, it is. So
I appreciate your honesty.
I need to. Oh, yeah. My toolbar went away. Our hotbar. Reload. I need to do that.
Oh, likewise. Good call.
Gotta feed your guns.
Sure, me too.
Gotta feed the guns.
Yeah, gotta feed them like it's a Pez dispenser. All right.
I like that analogy.
Whenever you're ready.
It's good. Right. Oh, I'm back on directed.
I'm opening the door. You guys ready?
Let's do it.
Yes, sir.
Boom.
It's a hallway.
All right. It's a hallway. And you see a wall 10 feet in front of you.
So diabolical.
Oh, yes.
What kind of dick would put a hallway here?
So you see a door. You see a door to the north and a door to the south. Both leading east.
Well, I think I know where this door goes.
North side.
Yeah, you've been there before. It's a little torture chamber.
Yeah, I'll just open that one.
The punishment room.
Yes.
The fun
does
has
Do I hear anything on the other side of this door? I put my ear up to it.
It's kind of the same sounds you've been hearing, just like dungeon sounds. I don't know.
Dungeon sounds. Okay.
Skittering of rats.
Skittering of rats
rafters.
And that kind of thing. Yeah.
Sure.
I should probably get those scene sounds back here. There we go.
All right, I'm opening this door, boys. You ready? You got your gun ready?
Yeah. Yep. He gives you the nod, like.
And so, what you see in front of you is a room that you've been in before. This is one of the first rooms you had entered. Just kind of coming in from a different angle here.
Well, that's pretty cool. I do believe we need to.
We looped around.
I think Justin gave us a map. Yep. Of the doors that we still needed to, I think he posted it a few days ago, like doors that we haven't checked or something.
Yeah. So here are all the doors. You got a set of double doors here. Yeah, this one, it seems to have some kind of sparkly glowing stuff going on there. And then you got the door here in front of you. There are some doors to the south you still have not checked yet.
Do you guys want to go north here and see what's up?
Pick a door. Pick any door.
Let's do the double doors since we're close to those, kind of, most of
these
us.
These two?
Yeah.
Probably a big room, right? You ready?
Yeah. Big boom. Fun.
Boom.
Okay, who's opening up the other one? Namjad? Yeah. All right, we'll have him open.
I mean,
that
I can
one.
Open both doors. I could just go like, you know what I mean?
Yeah, do the dramatic like push.
We got to make this cinematic. And then I...
yeah.
All right.
I think Sol would just walk in. He's feeling pretty confident.
All right. Let me,
yeah.
Let me
well,
tell
I mean,
you
after that last
combat,
here. I can understand why.
All right. So several wide alcoves adorn the walls of this L-shaped hallway. Each alcove contains a small diorama of the same city facing different perils. Massive fire, a devastating tsunami, a thunderous earthquake, an attack by an enormous tentacled monster, and an invasion of an army of undead.
Could be the city's history.
Are you saying all these like little circular spots, that's they have things on them?
That's right.
Is that what we're seeing? Okay. Where is the one that has the undead in it?
Oh, let me take a look here.
If it's not connected to something on the map, you could just arbitrarily, unless it's like a chronological whatever.
Yeah, I didn't know. That's why I was asking.
Yeah. Well, I mean, I was saying just...
Game's paused anyways. I can't move, so...
Yep. these look kind of cool. It seems like some sort of like illusion magic is being used in each of these. Like flames are flickering. There's like water rippling.
That was going
and,
to be my question. Is
yeah.
I wanted to search them for magic.
Can I cast? You said it's. Is it like a hologram kind of? Can I just rub like pass my hand through one of
can
them?
Can I
see
cast
what
detect magic and look at them?
You can.
Do like a perception?
Mm-hmm.
All right. I will cast... Bop, 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 bop. Detect magic.
Bop, bop, ba-da.
Detect cows.
I will place a 30-foot emanation,
this is my first
I guess.
Time noticing that Sherman's thing is a bunch of cards.
So...
Oh, that's cool. That's new.
I love that. Animation.
Oh man,
it's
that's
so
really
cool.
Cool. And I guess I will roll a perception. Great.
All right, so 13.
Can I also assist Namjad as he also checks stuff out? He's an investigator. He would probably know all sorts of stuff.
Yeah.
But he's been stupefied.
Also, remember that if it is a check that he does not have, I think he gets to add his level to it, or half his level.
Oh, probably half
plus
level.
Plus his intelligence.
Okay. Well, yeah, you can take a look at this one here. One second here.
He likes to invest gators.
He likes to put gators
has,
in vests.
Yes. It's kind of his thing.
But he's going to roll
gator
religion. Did he get? Okay. He's not quite sure about this.
Oh, it's to your level. It's not half your level, it's your full level.
And as he is looking at this thing, this one here in particular...
So I guess technically that would be a 15?
Nope, he still doesn't know.
You can recall pertinent facts on topics that aren't your speciality. Your proficiency bonus to untrained skill checks. is to recall knowledge is equal to your level instead of zero.
Oh, yeah.
So if he's trained in it, like he is with religion, he doesn't get the bonus.
Well, but...
But yeah, if he wants to recall knowledge on anything else, literally anything else, which is good for his devise a stratagem.
And so
he gets a plus.
He went up to this one. This is the one that has like flames.
Three.
And as he goes up to it, like there's like a diorama of a lighthouse. And it glows and glows and glows and like bright. Like you've seen this kind of thing happen before in real life. And then a beam shoots out from it right towards Namjoon.
Can I roll a
apocalypse
reflex
beam
to push him out of the way?
Holy!
Can I roll a reflex save to push him out of the way and take it?
Apocalypse beam. Wow, that sounds terrible.
Well, we've just killed Tron's character.
No, okay. He's not dead. He does go down though. Holy shit.
Is he like fire? Does he have fire resistance as a Tief? Is he a Tief?
No. But yeah, no, he gets he goes down as this beam of fire just flies out of this thing.
Oh no.
Okay. I'd like to help him if he's helpable, if that's an option.
Well, I have potions. I can give him a potion.
He may not have died immediately, but he came close.
He did.
If that
I think...
had been another 18 points of damage, he would have been dead.
18. Yep.
35 out of 52.
If you take double your
so you would need to take 70 in one shot.
Die immediately. Mm-hmm.
Well, I'll give him a potion since I'm standing right next to him.
All right.
And I'll start rolling med rolls here.
So, you can hit the use button there if you want, or I don't know.
Have to do that. Okay, I was sure if you were gonna. All right. Holy balls!
That's my one good roll for the night.
That's really good.
That's all you guys get.
Okay, so he gets 17 plus whatever he gets.
Well, that's also it's two crits. So that would be 8d8 plus whatever the plus whatever the potion gives him.
So he's probably back up to full here.
He's back to full right there.
Probably just dragged him out of there and.
Oh yeah. Yeah.
I'd like to go up to the next one and I would like to try and disarm it if at all possible. Is there anything I can do to give myself a bonus to this?
So hold on here, just make sure my clock's right here. So you guys spent like a whole hour at this point fixing him up. 2 hours?
It'd have been two hours for Jeb's med rolls.
I mean, he almost died.
Okay.
2 hours seems like...
I'll do an hour, and then it takes 10 minutes to do that, right?
Yeah. He's just immune to it for now.
So he's immune to it for now. Are you going to wait an hour in case he needs it again, or just continue on at six...
With
an hour and 10 minutes having passed.
Yeah, that's fine.
I'm
gonna roll a perception check. Do I
7
see
o'clock,
anything that?
He can
or wait,
more.
I'm gonna roll a perception check to see if I see anything that looks trap worthy or anything like that. Never mind.
Huh?
I'd like to.
You don't notice much, but
go to this one over here.
No, I don't.
Are you gonna go right in front of it?
No, I'm not going to go. I'd like to like lean around the corner, so I'd like to be able to like stand where
Soul
is.
Okay.
And like see if I can.
Sorry, I'm pausing.
Yeah.
I forgot.
And see if I can disarm the trap.
Sure. That's a thievery trying... check.
I know. Is there anything that I can do to increase my check? Can anybody give me like the help action or something?
Let's see here. To help with that, you have to be trained.
I'm trained in thievery.
Are you?
Jeb yeah. wouldn't know anything about it.
So oh, wait, no, I'm untrained.
Untrained as well for Namiad.
You straight laced motherfuckers.
So you do have to be trained to help then, is that?
I imagine so. I mean, yeah. Someone who doesn't know shit wouldn't do much to help.
Yeah, that's how it was in 1E and 5E and stuff. Yeah.
Does no one else have thievery?
So you rolled a 20 on this thing, huh?
Yep.
That's pretty good.
So you are working away at it and kind of you know, using your tools and...
Can I hold on to his back?
You see that light on the lighthouse flickers and dims.
Oh, thank God.
20 must have been the DC.
Do
we have to disable all of these?
Yeah, you nailed it, man. That was exactly what you needed.
Because I can like just hold on to you if it starts looking bad, maybe Justin could have me roll a reflex save or something. I could just pull you. Look back.
Did Namiya trigger it just by looking at it or by him hitting a pressure plate? Or does Namiya, is he aware enough of the mechanism?
It seemed to be like a motion.
Motion.
Of some kind, yep.
Okay.
Can I grab one of these boards?
Chuck it.
And then just wave them in front of these things.
Yeah, set off a trap. Yeah.
Yeah. So I'm gonna grab a board.
Here's the thing. Actually, before you do that, I want to step up here in front of this thing.
Yeah.
Do I see any difference between the one where the trap did go off and the one where the trap didn't?
Well, this one has a scene of fire. A lot of flames and such. The other one it was a devastating tsunami had come through and destroyed the city.
But does it look like is this one over here like destroyed or anything? It still looks fine though, right?
Intact. Like the diorama's intact.
Yeah, it's all intact. It's all fine. Okay. It just, there was a beam that launched out from the lighthouse.
Yeah, okay, that's the case. Let's just set these motherfuckers off and let them.
That's what I was gonna do.
Let's just go nuts.
What's this? Is that anything?
Like a sconce or something? I don't know. I never noticed that.
Okay, just making sure. Okay, can I wave it's my board?
It's nothing of importance.
Can
yeah.
I use lunge to wave my board 10 feet away?
Yeah, another beam of light fires out, and from this diorama, which has this one seems to have been devastated by an earthquake. Buildings have been smashed to pieces.
Okay,
I have a question. Wait, I have a question for you, Justin.
Yeah.
Did the beam follow the board, or did it horizontally shoot out?
I'd say it just horizontally shot out.
We could just crawl under these, dude.
I was thinking that. But if we just trip them and...
But I mean, like, disarming them is probably the better bet.
It's probably the safer bet, but something tries to come up behind us. Those traps are still there.
I suppose...
We're aware of them. But here's the other problem. If we need a fast escape.
Well, yeah, that's what I was going to say. And it may be one of those things where we need, like, a... I don't know. acrobatics check or a stealth check to be able to get through unscathed. Like, I imagine it's still going to be check dependent, and that is the thing that I'm worried about, because a failure is going to suck, as we've already seen.
Yeah.
So let's see. Let's just disable.
Doesn't have to attack, and it did crit on Naviad.
Oh, it crit? Is that why he almost died?
Yeah, it crit.
Oh. Well. Yeah.
There are two left here.
Plus 16. So it's gonna destroy us. I mean, I'm metagaming at this point.
But well, I like. Here's the thing. I don't even think this is metagaming, because I think like we are. This would definitely be something we would be talking about.
We've seen it twice now. Yeah. We've seen the beam activated twice. So.
Here's what I would say.
Give me another board. Somebody bring me another board. Let's see if this thing.
Jeff brings you another board.
It can be multiple shots.
Yeah.
Okay. So I'm gonna put it in front of it again. Does it go off again?
No. This one? No. Nothing happens after that.
Interesting.
So here's what I would say. Let's. If you want to like stand around the corner there and set this trap off, it does shoot a beam. So I'm gonna go ahead and stand around the corner here.
Yeah.
All right.
Best of luck to you.
I'm going to quickly pass in front of this one, like very quickly, because I am worried that it's going to go off.
Naruto Ninja Run.
Does it?
No, it doesn't go off.
Okay. Okay. And then I'm going to put my trusty board in front of this guy.
This one. Has a big monster in front of it, and again, there's a beam of light, very similar
a
to the ones.
A beam of tentacles comes out.
Yeah, I'm gonna.
And you hear the board just go ooh woo.
Tentacle beam.
I'm just rolling this for fun. Geez. But yeah, that would have been a 32 there. So.
Hey, it's a good thing we didn't decide to fuck with these.
That would have been 40.
32 would be a crit. That's 10
if it
over.
Was so 46. that board just explodes in your hand. You get like shrapnel everywhere.
Jeb would just bring you another board for the next trap.
We got our plan right. Oh, I feel nervous standing in front of this.
Oh, I guess
thing.
That
it's
was
like
mental damage. So I guess, yeah, you nothing that would not have
still
happened.
Intact.
The board's mind
for the
did
last
not get
one,
blown because it doesn't have one.
For the last one, Sherman wants to draw something on the board before the trap gets set off.
Jeb's gonna bring me the board, so just draw on it, hand it to Jeb.
Yeah. What do I want
to
draw?
I have to see
on
your
the board.
Stupid picture.
I'm so good
what would piss Sol off?
I don't even think it's about pissing Sol off. I think I want to draw something that I'm going to enjoy.
Yeah,
watching
but you know, you're going to be all the way across the hall staring at me while Jeb brings me a board, and then I see the picture, and it's just you waving down the hall at me. Is all I imagine with your stupid picture.
I'm trying to think of who's pissed us off at this point. I think I love
it. We all like Zoggle's the only one that hated
I didn't like Urok at first, but I grew to like
him. He grew on us, yeah. He grew on us.
I think I'm going to draw
playing Ed and Eddie.
No.
What about that stupid sprite thing that's at our place?
Yeah, you know what? I'm gonna draw a Zoggle fart on there. I'm gonna just write a little caption that says, "I'll fight the energy beam."
Yeah.
Put me in, coach.
So I get this board. I see Zoggle fart, and I kind of like look at it, and I kind of look at.
Here he goes.
Gamble.
Kind of like you know he would.
Yeah, he would have. He would have. This thing would have killed him three times already. Yeah. Let's be honest, Nathan.
Yeah.
Zaga no. wouldn't have made it through this.
No, I said as much last episode. I was like, yeah, him making it to level 8, it's just his decision making doesn't lend
itself. It's unfeasible.
Yeah, no.
I'm going to take this last board.
Unfortunately.
I'm going to take this last board. You can make me roll for it or not, but I just want four Zoggle, essentially. Oh, Jesus.
That's really close to killing a character outright.
I'm just going to throw it in front of the beam. 60 points of
negative damage that flies out from this diorama full of undead of all sorts of different kinds.
Wow.
Some you're familiar with and some you've never seen before.
Oh, look, they do different things.
Fire in the hole.
Oh, that's so cool.
Yeah, every single beam was a different
type of... What did that first beam do?
The first one did fire damage. The second
fire.
One was...
fire.
Mental or something.
What is this one? You said this was like
bludgeoning damage. Yeah, this is bludgeoning damage.
Ah, okay.
The third one was sonic.
Oh, some Cyclops
so
shit.
Next one is mental, and the next one was negative.
Wait, what does this one do?
Okay.
Here, I'll ping mental. Each. I'll ping each one.
That one fire. Did bludgeoning. Oh,
this was
fire.
Bludgeoning.
Bludgeoning. Sonic.
Oh.
Sonic.
Mental. Negative.
Mental.
Well, chances are the sonic damage was also mental damage because of all of the inflation, porn and whatnot.
Yep.
Rolling around at the speed
gotta go
of
fast.
Sound.
All right.
So you guys do see now that you've successfully set off all of these traps here.
Now my only apprehension
set of double doors at the end here
is that if anything is in there, it is acutely aware of our presence by this point.
Yeah, I've been chucking boards around here.
Oh, shit.
Well, we might as well make a grand entrance, hard. And I want to push, again, both doors open.
I'm going
to
back up.
All right.
Oh, yeah.
Doors are called open. It. And at this point, you see something that you have seen before. It's not in these vaults. It was in your own home, back at the fish camp. This
is it
is
that
what
ghost guy?
No.
No.
It's not a ghost. This is the big creature that was in your fish camp that had several creepy crawlies under its charge. And here we see it's here.
Oh.
Well, it's Frank.
It's got like a...
Oh!
Mandibles here, several eyes, and scythes for hands, basically, with some smaller claws
say,
on there, too.
Get
this is
baby,
what you'd
dude.
Call
get
a web lurker. And as you guys open web the door, it is like sitting there waiting for you. And then as you walk in, it jumps up on the table. And...
Aw, that's what I was gonna do.
It says...
Dude, he stole my move.
And it seems to be speaking at you. But, seems some weird guttural language.
Does
any of you speak
like
Aklo?
Trying to communicate, or is it...
It is nope. Definitely trying to communicate with
no.
you guys.
Actually, Jeb knows some weird language for being a skeleton. What is it?
Necro?
It is... Yeah, definitely not Aklo.
Sorry, I didn't stream it.
Wait a minute.
You. There we go.
Necrol.
Yeah, it's speaking
Tengu?
Aklo.
Did you say Tengu? Yeah, I speak that.
Aklo.
Oh,
more of an
Aklo.
Aberration Common? Type thing.
It's a very rare language, I think.
Hold up.
So it's just sitting there.
We're not in combat, right?
talking at you guys. So what are you guys doing as it's just trying to talk to you?
Putting it in my
I want to
casting a spell on us.
Can I try and it looks intelligent. Can I try and I do believe I have like some charcoal and some paper. Can I try and like write down hello in like a few different languages and then like mage hand it a piece of paper? Because I do have a comprehension elixir that would let me understand any written communication it does.
Wait, what if we gave him the comprehension elixir?
Then we still wouldn't be able to understand what he's saying. And it only works on written language.
But he, with scythe hands, can he really write anything, you know?
Possibly.
One would think probably not.
Yeah.
I won't even have to make you roll for that one.
Turns out he's a wheat farmer. That'd be hilarious.
Comprehension elixir is a bitter draught. Open your mind.
A harvest way.
You can understand any words you read.
Piss off.
So you go ahead and
What if we gave him the elixir and then we wrote things down? I know we wouldn't understand what he's saying, but we could still.
Yeah, I just kind of like offer it up to him. I sort of like moving into the room. I offer it up. I'm just sort of like, hey, here you go.
All right. So yeah, the paper goes ahead and lands up on its at its table there, which has like a bunch of webs and stuff like all over it. And it kind of looks and examines it, and then it looks up at you, and then it begins speaking at you again, and seems like polishing his claws as he's speaking to you as well.
I think I use this moment of distraction to I don't know that this guy
yeah, he's standing on the
table. Can I kind of like wink at the Namiad and tell and ask him to be like, just real quick, I kind of want to like go through, make a big show of going through my bag again, being like trying to look for like some parchment or something, and just be like,
so you're like up, tell me, are you way back here as you're doing this?
Yeah I'm kind of like going through my bag and being, and I just want to be like, Namiad, does this guy speak common? Can he make a check? Oh, he doesn't seem to.
Will make a check on this guy. Let me check his
okay. I was gonna say
it's an occultism check.
I don't know that this guy is, I don't know.
He's of the devil.
Yeah, I was gonna say, let's use this moment of confusion to just get the drop on this guy. This thing.
Damn. All right, so he rolled an 18, right, which is what he needed.
All right, good.
You guys are nailing skill checks here, which is very contrary to.
Usually do, yes.
Yeah, he goes, yeah, this is a web lurker, just like the one we saw before. Remember, it's got poison. It speaks Aklo and spider. Be careful, there's probably a bunch of traps in there like last time. Remember, Zogglefart got new stuff.
Does he seem friendly? Do you know that much?
No, the last one wasn't friendly. I don't know why this one would be.
He seemed to get a little excited when you sent him a little gift there. And now he's like, seeming to come, like, really, like, becoming more and more agitated. And
speaking
more hurriedly.
I'm going to draw and shoot.
All right.
I think we have to roll initiative.
Now it's time for initiative.
Yeah. I kind of hope you guys get higher initiative this time, to be honest.
Here is my question. Can I roll? Can I roll like stealth? Because I was sneaking around, like.
Yeah, absolutely.
All right. Excellent. Yeah.
Well, and that is like just
or you, if you want like deception.
My deception is really bad.
Yeah, take stealth in. That's fine.
Okay.
Yeah, void notice is like Jeff's default exploration activity. But his initiative and stealth are the same.
Oh, I get to roll Nami in here.
You are strong, and that's the problem.
Yeah, just roll it, whatever. Natural two. All right. Beginning counter. Here we go.
Well, I suppose it could have been thievery too, because I was like trying to sneakily do my gun as I was in my bag and just. Yeah!
So like this guy became very seeing that you guys had worked doing what it was telling you to do, and just frustrated at the communication here, he's gonna just leap forward and attack. And he managed to get the jump on you guys before you guys could do it. So he's going for the nearest target here, which is of course Soul. And he's gonna launch forward with his.
Fuck.
Ugh.
Natural 20.
Oh, it's poison too.
Please roll a fortitude save.
You're good at those, right?
It's a fighter, I think.
Sometimes. Not this time.
Yep. So here's what happens. You take 28 points of damage.
Okay.
28 points.
I'm almost dead, guys. Wait, how did I take so much?
There's a crit and poison and all that crap.
I know, but I took like 30 some points of damage.
I mean, we deal like 30 and 50s and stuff on our crits.
I only clicked it once. It says it once.
Yeah, I went from. Maybe I'm.
Yeah, 28 plus 14 is.
42. Oh, no, I'm just mathing wrong. Okay.
Yeah, that's right. and then
I'm almost dead, guys.
I don't think. Yeah, you'd have to critically fail a fortitude save. So you're in stage one of this poison, and it says 1d6 poison damage, and you are flat-footed.
I can't be caught flat-footed. No, that's not this game.
Wrong character. so you need to take 2 points of. Poison damage.
Okay.
All right.
And I'm flat-footed.
Not good. All right.
Oh, Boise.
And guess what? He's not alone here, guys.
Mm-hmm.
Dropping down is.
How did everyone manage to beat our initiative.
Yes. You guys used all your luck on your skill checks. Here's where it hurts.
I told you should have given him the potion.
let's see. What's I even actually looked at this, guys. He was hidden and I didn't see him. okay. Spider stuff. All right.
At least we didn't go into the room.
Yeah, boy, would that have been a problem.
That is true, yes.
That is the only good thing.
So his speed's 25, so he's going to scuttle. I like that word, scuttle.
Okay.
sorry. let's see, he's going to go right here. So he'll move. And then he's going to shoot Namyad with a ranged attack. Launches a web right at him. Oh, it went right underneath my trigger.
Why not?
And it flies right over his head and sticks to the wall. He'll try again, though. Let's see if he can do that more than once in a turn or anything weird like that. Oh shoot, it's 10 feet range, so he would have had to been here. So it goes here, it does that. Ranged attack, would that incur an attack of opportunity?
It would.
Yes, it would.
Now's your chance, bud.
Alright. Two-handed katana.
Yeah, if you could just, like, absolutely destroy this thing.
Targeted the wrong guy. The spider, 21 against the spider.
21. That is a hit.
Yeah. Damage.
Alright, not bad.
17 points of damage.
Yeah. Alright, nice. Yes, yeah, 17 points.
And he's poisoned 10.
He's... Despite how injured are, you just whirled around real fast and you just cut it right in half.
You love to see it.
What happened to someone else? I need someone to heal me.
You love to see it.
He has no vitality. Let's continue. That's all he's got.
Seeing how dirty he done my boy, I gotta drop a bomb on this dude.
Oh, I should have taken my potion.
He is badly injured. And I don't know if there's more spiders or what the hell in there. Yeah, I'm going to dump it. I'm going to cast True Strike.
Ooh.
And then I'm going to dump
Roll a
Shocking Grasp as I...
Holy shit. you are dumping.
Wow. Big boy damage here. The last time it was like 40 damage or something.
So I do believe I roll twice. So yeah. Let me make sure that I'm targeting this guy. So strike. 18.
18's a miss.
So strike again.
23 is a hit.
If you do a hero point, do you have to take the thing that you rolled?
Yeah.
Ah, shit. I will take the hit then. So I was really hoping for a critical there. Damage 6.
That's not bad.
But then that's average. Shocking Grasp.
Oh, I like that 10.
All right.
So 21 damage.
All right. Boy. Yeah. Yeah. All that damage seemed to have gone through.
Hey, that's also good.
Got Zeus over here fucking with his lightning gun.
So that is it for my turn. That's 3 actions.
I got another scuttler here. You killed his brother. Now he's going to come in and try and do some damage here. You think he's just going to run up in here and go after Mr. Namiad?
He would take an
step
into your square.
You already used your reaction, though.
He
right?
moved in my threat. Oh,
you
I did
already use your reaction. He,
yeah.
And yeah, you did use your reaction. Sucks. And besides, he didn't leave your square.
He stepped
thing.
Through. He stepped because he had to step
that's
here.
What you're saying. I see what you're saying.
It steps through.
Gotcha. Yeah, that would do it. All right. Well, let's see what he can
if he
get.
Just, if he went like up here though, and then stepped around the corner. Then
ooh, that is a natural 18 on the die, and but not a crit.
All right.
Gom. And Namiya takes 2 points of damage, and he needs to make a fortitude save. Okay.
He needs to make a fortress save.
Okay, 12 on the die, and that is a success. So,
hell yeah.
Cool, man.
Great success.
We had a move and a bite. I've got one more left here. He'll just keep biting on me, I think. Unless there's something I'm missing here. All right, I did all that stuff.
Oh, it turns out that he can just melt his insides whenever he wants to.
And that's a miss, and that's his turn. All right, Father Jib.
Father Jib.
So if my last attack was successful, does that account? Does that count for my reaction, or does it have to be like an action?
I would say it counts
for you to get. Okay.
I'll say it counts unless someone smarter than me tells me differently.
I think it's, is it against the same person or is it against, I should know that.
Oh, yeah. I think it might be against the same person.
I think it is.
He is no longer a person.
I'm pretty sure it is. So I'm gonna target some.
He is mush.
Yeah. Take that, dumb bitch. Well, we'll see if he take, well.
Yeah, 18, it's the same person.
18 is a miss.
Yep. Yeah. Cool.
19 is the number.
To move and then do medicine, battle medicine.
It's the magic number.
I think that's the one. I think it's 19. Yeah.
It's whatever. I don't give a shit. that's what it is. Okay.
All right. That's a success, right?
Assault levels horizon, boys. Well, there you go.
I'll take what I can get. I'll take what I can get.
I heard you like salt, so here's your salt for your salt factor.
Do you want me to add that, Justin?
The air is salt. Sure. The walls are salt.
And that is your turn. Oh, all right, so yeah. What are you gonna do? Save your ass.
He's only been in like six combats, so he's just washed up. I love it.
Oh, this is facts. Tough. I'm right facts. Here.
Some demonic shit.
I got a katana in hand. Here. Do I do what Soul does and just attack him?
It has to be you. You're the chosen. You're like the chosen one.
Chosen one.
Chose Simba.
All right. I'm attacking the big boy for the boys.
It's gotta be you.
Am I still flat-footed?
Yeah.
I think so.
How do I remove that? Like, how am I flat-footed? Like, why
you
am
go to
I
an orthopedic surgeon.
Let me look at
because of the poison.
Venom.
I was like,
yeah.
Venom and just being poison makes me flat-footed.
Yeah. Yeah, I think you would.
You get a save.
How do I remove
a save again at the end of your turn? I think is how it works.
Okay.
Okay. That's what I needed to know how to remove the problem. So.
Yep.
But whatever. I'm going to slice this dude in half, so.
27's a hit. Not a crit, but it's a hit.
You are, like, absolutely killing it with these rolls.
It's good. It's good that someone is.
All right. Yeah, you're targeting the web lurker? Yep. Okay.
Yes, I am.
Oh, man.
All right. Cool. Yeah, takes 17 damage.
So there's something about this guy. Okay. I gotta look at a gem quick.
Oh, your fear gem? Or,
yeah.
He is almost dead.
Fear gem.
That's what I'm.
You look at.
I was curious.
It makes you scared, bro.
Does it just. That's what I'm wondering, though. Will it scare this other spider? Is what I'm saying. You know what I mean?
The mechanic, how it works.
Hmm.
So it's sort of, it looks like it's sort of like my, spell strike. Yeah. You activate it. It takes two actions. And if you hit it, it's a, fear one.
Where is this gem?
Frightened one.
No, it's
it
frightened
in your
two.
Or something?
And frightened then if it's two a crit, on it's... a critical hit.
No, frightened three on a critical.
Really?
Oh, if you have the feat. Never mind. If you already had the feat, then it ups it by one.
Okay. All the intimidating, whatever. Yeah.
Yeah. I was wondering if it would affect creatures around me, but it shatters their confidence. And so I'm not going to waste it. I'm just going to slice again. I was just checking.
Oh, okay. Oh, it only has one charge.
Yep.
Yeah.
It's consumable.
So I don't want to just waste it.
Yeah.
17.
God damn, these rolls, man.
Fantastic. That's a hit. Roll your damage.
Really.
11 points. And with that, it falls.
Not up
it
in the house.
Foil.
Yeah, your sword boy, goes right into his gut, and he just kind of slides right off of your blade. Now roll a fortitude save.
My turn's not over.
He's still got one more.
You got one more action left.
I got one more action.
He's going to have to reload his sword.
Took us a while. And it usually Soul is so fast. It's a 1-2-3 thing, right? So, let's attack this stupid spider. I mean, I probably won't hit it, but
I bet you,
spider idiot.
Your chances of hitting him right now are higher than mine doing my first attack.
My God! Yep. Okay.
You hit him.
Atta boy.
Nine.
Yeah, you stabbed him.
Take those. Hits him all three of his attacks. I love it.
And
now for
that's
you,
everything.
Justin.
For me.
Oh, yeah,
thank you very much. So you went from stage one of this poison, stage zero.
Hey,
you're all right.
Fucking the most based turn in the world.
That
what
was
a
good.
Turn, dude. What a
that's,
turn.
Wow, what a
what
turn.
A heel
I'd
turn.
Say. So please, you can remove your flat-footed condition then. You are no longer flat-footed. You shook off the poison.
Did it.
All right, Nami is up next.
Wow. Hey,
All right.
Those 4 points of heal,
go,
that's
yeah.
that whole thing in action. I just felt so good.
Oh, man. What's he got now? I think he's just going to draw his rapier and just go at this thing.
Oh,
march
then I get
for
an
death. I mean, you sure could.
We never get to use it.
There you go.
That's a 13.
It feels right, you know.
Yeah, he's still kind of dumb. So, let's try again.
Oh, devise a stratagem is you can toggle that on and off. Okay.
Oh, really?
It looks like it.
He's just going for attacks. This it looks like.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I mean, this thing's almost dead.
If there's party stuff, sometimes you can
might as well. Yeah.
And that's a miss too.
Jesus Christ.
Go for.
Can somebody just put a bullet in this thing?
I mean, he's not gonna hit it. I mean, we'll just
any Pathfinder party.
We'll try again. He's got a negative one on this roll here, but
you can roll a 20
or a two. Hey, it's not a
is
one. It's not a
is
one.
That a crit
one.
Fail? Though, what's
no, it's a critical miss.
He got a two, a three, and a four.
Yeah.
All right.
Can we only do the card
gamble.
Turn?
What are you doing?
Nah. Two, a four, and a four.
Okay.
Gamble is going to reload.
Shoot the
just,
chair in the other
just being like,
just shoot this thing.
Gotta,
it's a spider.
Do everything around here.
all the way in the back. All the way in the back.
Yeah, just being like, Namiad. He is going to, make a strike.
Hey, there we go.
That is a hit.
Is it a regular hit?
Yeah. Regular ass hit.
Damn.
You had to be close, though.
He takes 8 points of damage and dies.
Oh, thank God.
Yeah. And then Gamble uses his next two actions to flourish his gun and blow the smoke off of it.
Nice.
And Soul uses all his actions to put his hands on his knees.
To collapse into a pile and bleed.
Yeah.
I had to kill everything. And then I had to fight off a poison.
Kill the poison
I mean,
inside.
I definitely loosened up the one.
Okay, so that's a crit success. So far it's
Nabi is gonna do some battle medicine too. Let's see here.
68 for here. That's for you, Soul.
Medicine. Pew pew.
Yum.
It's the only thing I've been able to roll today. You still need some. Oh, uninjured. All right.
Do I see anything in here with a 19?
I clicked the wrong guy here. Sorry. I was rolling someone's medicine check, but not the one I intended. There we go. 16 in the die. For Nami, that's a 22. So that's, what, it's 2d8, you said?
Yeah, 2d8.
For regular success? Okay.
Yep, yep.
All right, there you go. 11 or 10 points, I think it was. Yep. You get 10 more. Oh, you already healed up to full soul?
Yeah.
Well, Sherman could use some help, and I can get Nami.
I'm down by 4 points. I think Sherman's fine.
Well, he just helped you out anyway.
Well, so. I mean, well, here's the thing. I suppose if it's only going to take 10 minutes, it's better to do it than I'm not
already,
do it.
Yeah, because I already rolled twice for soul.
So,
So might as well
roll something to zero to what's your check? 19.
You and your medicine checks.
Yeah, those are incredibly important. So it's good that you're rolling those so well. Let me add 10 minutes here as you guys are doing that. Let's see here.
Let's see, that would be.
So you're looking around. You are able to find some treasure. Under the table.
You said that there was probably some nooses around here, right? Do I see
that's
any
it,
of those?
Nami said. Oh. Yeah, you do see a couple in the room.
Who's that for?
It's Nami. He takes a D8.
Here and here.
He's going to take a D8.
Oh, okay.
And under the table, you also find some treasure.
I was going to say, I do have like a rapier. Can I just slice those down real quick?
Absolutely. Yeah.
Okay. Okay. Wow. And treasure.
Here, been... I can heal. I can heal.
Yeah. Yeah. His hands are tired or something, or arthritis.
Oh, do we have some people join us?
Oh,
there you go. We did. Welcome.
Yeah. Welcome.
At the worst time, after the fight's unfortunate.
Yeah.
As we're healing each other.
Yeah. As we're licking our wounds.
All right, yeah. So you did find some webs here, and inside of that, you did find some valuables, at least what he thought was valuable. Yeah. A lot of worthless stuff, rusty arrowheads, shiny rocks, bits of glass, some
shiny
seashells.
Rocks is pretty cool. I do like shiny rocks.
A mesmerizing opal.
Ooh, that's a shiny rock.
There you
Five
go.
Shining sling bullets.
Are these chests?
And a necklace.
Do you have like a chest that we can open or something?
Not that I'm finding here.
Well, shit. if you want to just I guess dump it in someone's inventory and we can look from there.
Yeah, I do anything to investigate any of these things.
I will cast detect magic, I suppose.
That necklace is definitely magical.
Sherman's just gonna be like, well, I suppose those sling bullets look interesting, but I'll take a look at this necklace, I suppose. Oh, is that an opal? My, that must be worth something. Maybe we could even put it in this necklace.
Maybe roll an arcana check for me.
Go ahead and take it. You can have it. Just take it.
That's a decent one.
All right. Let me see if I can find this.
No one's arguing.
Item. Okay, let's see if I mystify.
Bite into a head of lettuce.
What?
So did you just bite into a head of lettuce?
No, I'm not a complete psychopath. That was a mint bonbon that I put in my mouth.
Okay. That was just very crunchy as all.
A mint bonbon that I was hiding.
Here is what you found.
What was that? Oh, necklace of fire. Ooh.
This is a type 1 necklace of fireballs.
I feel like Aaron should get it, even though he's not Sim and he's not here. And
he hasn't been here. I feel the like string stuff of beads like that. Appears to be a hemp string with lustrous red beads of various sizes hanging from it. When activated, it briefly appears in its true form. Golden chain with golden spheres attached by fine threads. Necklace has 1d6 fire damage and 2d6 fire damage beads with a DC 21 basic reflex save. When all the beads are gone, the necklace becomes a non-magical hemp string.
How many beads are on it?
So you remove this bead and chuck it.
The classic. Definitely wear it.
I don't know if I would be the best person to have it. I mean, I am usually away from the action is the thing.
Mm-hmm. Or at least hold on to it for
I'll hold on to it for right now. I'm actually Nami a bad person to have it.
Here's the other one. I think it said mesmerizing oboe, which is an actual item. I thought they were just describing it, but no, that is a thing.
Okay.
Sounded really specific, yeah. Like it's some item.
Yeah. Come on, what is going on? Yeah, it is. Yes, mesmerizing opal. You attempt a deception check to faint, but you haven't rolled yet. Is a trigger? It's a fire with iridescence. When you activate it, the outcome of your triggering deception check is a critical failure. You get a failure instead. Or if the outcome is success, you get a crit success.
Does anybody here actually have ranks in deception? Nope. Actually, Namiad is an expert in that. I say we give that one to him.
Yeah.
Deception.
Yeah, faint is deception.
Yeah.
Dreams are inception.
Plus, I already have a feat that does that.
He is deception.
I get the squawk. Noise.
Well, faint is combat.
Not for faint, but for a deception check.
Okay, now he has that, I believe. Let me check his sheet, make sure it went through. Inventory, mesmerizing, yep, there it is. Okay, cool. And then the necklace of fireballs, who's going to get that one?
I suppose I'll hang on to it for right now.
Sherman.
Okay, type one.
You mean you're going to wear it, you're going to look dope with it.
And then we have some magical sling bullets as well. It just said... Oops. Sorry. All right. 5 shining sling bullets.
I'll take bullets, I guess. I don't know. I don't have a sling, but maybe I'll get one in the future.
Are they just magical in that they like shining use that to overcome damage reduction or?
Maybe we could transfer sling. It to actual bullets that we use instead of the
Yeah, I'm Black trying to find the items. I honestly didn't see it anywhere in my journals or anything. So usually they put this stuff in here.
Yeah, well, we can look at it later.
I was just searching for bullets. Nothing. Anyway, you have it.
Sure.
Any magical swords? No? Okay.
Nah, not this time, bud. There's no doors in this room.
I got that one sword. I get all the weapons because no one uses weapons. So nobody uses conventional weapons, I should say. Yeah. I don't know. Can Namiad wield a great axe?
I was gonna say with a what exactly is the deal with the sling bullets? You said they're magical in some way, right?
I think he can't find it on Foundry, so he just...
Here is what the text says.
Yeah.
Mesmerizing opal, 5 shining sling bullets. Type 1 necklace. And what is that, an enchantment? Shining?
Well, shining...
Like, brilliant weapons were... Well, they didn't use the word brilliant.
Shining ammunition. A piece of shining ammunition gives off a faint glow. When shot, this ammunition sheds bright light in a 20-foot radius and dim light to the next 20 feet for 10 minutes.
Ooh.
If it hits a target, it sticks, causing the target to shed light in the same radius. A creature can remove the ammunition with an interact action, but the ammunition itself continues to glow for the rest of the duration or until destroyed. It's it sounds like.
Okay.
So you would definitely be able to like know what square an invisible creature's in. Could I, with a successful craft check, transfer that enchantment over to, instead of sling bullets, gun bullets?
Do that in downtime. That would probably take quite some time, but yeah.
Okay. I'd
definitely give that a shot.
Well, we've...
Okay, where are we going now?
In the next room.
We cleared out rooms. How to add that, but nope.
It does look like there are...
Shining ammunition here.
Are there doors in this hallway? Oh yeah, there's these two. Ammunition.
Okay. So I'll just drag that into your thing, I guess. So you wanted that?
I say give those to Jeb, and then when the time comes, I can try and move that enchantment over for him.
Cool. Sounds good.
Cool.
So I deleted the normal sling bullets. Is that okay? There we go. So we got some shining bullets here.
There you go. All right. Cool. So you guys are... See, how much time did you guys spend in that room then?
How many checks did you make?
What, 10 minutes?
I did like, I think two or three checks for each person, maybe. I don't know. Probably okay, four so
spending
checks,
hours
maybe.
Then?
I think we spent like, no, I think you did. Did you do two checks on Namian?
Namian
healed. I don't know if he, I think he did one.
I wish there, yeah, that's the number.
So I think it was probably
so,
just
yeah,
about like an hour.
We do need to really
track
that because the time thing is actually really important for this adventure path.
Oh no.
Yeah. Each of those checks, 10 minutes. We're still in that room then here.
Okay.
Okay. Does that mean like we're just gonna get our whole shit pushed in because we dicked around too long?
Maybe it's a mechanic we're not supposed to know about, but tracking 10
yeah,
minute
but as a game master,
like...
I really need to know all each check and get it all tracked here. So
I don't like that.
That sounds tedious as hell. Tracking 10 minute increments, or hour increments, or whatever we're doing. But
yeah. So how long are you guys spending in this specific room? So let's see, Father Jeb did 10 minutes here.
Let's see.
So it'd be 20 minutes.
Namia did some healing too.
Three.
All right, we'll say you guys.
Sorry, you're muted, bud.
I did six checks. I forget who they're for.
It would have been like an hour and.
Wow.
You can do for different people. You don't have to like.
There was one. There, some of them were for Soul. Most of them were for Soul. I think I did two for Namia, and I don't know what the other two were for.
Okay, so you guys spent like an hour in here then?
He did one for me. I think he did two for Namian.
So two.
And I know he did a battle medicine for Soul, which would have been immediate.
That's immediate,
well, that
so doesn't matter.
That would have been the combat.
Yep.
Yeah.
And then
so,
I think
yeah,
he did an extra one
like...
there. So I think it was like two and a half hours, I think, would probably be about what it
and
is.
And Namian should be healed.
Okay. Okay.
Oh no. It got dark.
Yeah,
I don't know. I thought I had changed that. It should have been dark to begin with because of you're underground. Whatever.
The lighthouse.
But it got darker.
Hasn't been paying their utility bills for 300 years. All right.
So now you guys can do. You guys gonna get out?
Can you just put us by those doors?
All right. So Sherman, as you're walking out.
Like stuck.
That one
son
lighthouse.
Oh, it recharges.
Shines again.
Oh no.
And shoots right at you.
Oh,
That's why he was thinking about time.
Okay.
Yep.
It's like a rechargeable.
And this one was negative damage. And so let's see if it can hit you. It may miss. What was that?
Of course it doesn't.
That's a critical hit.
Of course it is. It has a plus 16.
I didn't roll very well on damage. You took 36 points of damage there.
I am down.
He's down.
Don't worry. I got you.
Instantly
I got
down.
You.
All right, so you learned that.
Get the chairs.
Get some chairs.
Get them and you get them now.
Can we tear these fucking dioramas out of the wall? Is that a mechanic? Where we just fucking destroy
now,
these things?
We're pissed as players. Okay, so there's two checks.
Okay, so you're gonna spend another hour, a couple hours in here? Right
well,
in front
I got,
of the diorama?
I got two checks so far.
Hold on. Think about this now. Think about this. It's recharge, and...
Dude, Jeb's senile as shit. He ain't thinking about this.
So, the party, you guys need to talk this over. See, what are you going to do? You're just going to let him sit here and do this.
I can't talk anything over.
I guess there's Namiad and there's Soul, so...
What? Okay, I'll do one check. And then he can do the board.
Because you can do a battle medicine.
Well, no, one check is 10 minutes. Or, well, right? Yeah.
Yeah, one check is 10 minutes.
Treat wounds is 10 minutes. Okay, so I guess.
Namiad
first...
will do a battle medicine on you because that's immediate, right? Then we don't have to do your death saving throws. He's just trying to set up
outside of combat.
Your medicine check's going to take 10 minutes, right? I think you could do it outside of combat. But... I mean, why not?
I mean, I can do battle medicine too.
Yeah, we're not fighting anything. It's just
how much tedium we want to deal with here.
All right, let's look at battle medicine.
Ah,
requirements: you are holding tools.
Yeah.
Even in combat, so it's based on language. I'd say it's done.
You can just use it regardless.
Sorry. So let's see if he can help you out with a check, then keep you from instantly dying here. Boy.
Nope.
That's shitty. And now I'm going to reuse his hero point.
Well, I mean, it's out of combat. And Jeb already rolled healing for him.
Come on.
Well, here's the thing. Jeb can also use combat medicine. He already rolled enough to... I'm only down. I'm only negative one hit point. Jeb rolled enough that he would be able
You're dying two. Critical hit. But if he's doing battle medicine, then you're good.
Yeah.
Sure. So we'll go with your battle medicine. I'll just not use his hero point then. It's fine.
Yeah.
All right. So as you roll the D8.
Yeah, I already did.
You did.
So
okay. 4D8. Isn't it 2D8?
Well, I was doing checks, like, you know, normally after whatever, someone takes damage, I just do two or three medicine checks. But so the first two were 3 and 8, so if you just want to put those down.
3 and 8? Okay.
Only one check or whatever.
All right, we'll do that then.
Yeah.
Okay.
And he's up. And wounded one.
Stand up.
Oh, and I do have my magical gloves I can use. But the question would be, if we use them, then we don't have them for the rest of the day here. So,
as soon as you're up, Sherman, Namiad, you're like, all right, how we get the fuck out of here? And then worry about this.
I do.
Well, Soul should have been doing the boards while we were doing this.
I'm just taking
all the traps
chairs.
Just fucking taking chairs and hawking
traps.
Them down the hallway.
Yeah. He would have been done way before us.
Explode some chairs. It's really too bad it wasn't Sherman that went out, because this thing shoots negative damage, which would have done nothing to him. Not Sherman.
Well, Sherman Jeb. Did go, yeah.
Jeb is what I meant.
Yeah, would have just been like, that felt nice.
Ooh, it felt good.
Yeah.
But Sherman's like, oh my fuck, and then he dies.
It's cramming. All those things just crit.
Yeah, imagine we.
Well, I mean, the thing has like, what did it say? It said it had like a +16. Yeah, that would be incredibly difficult for that thing not to crit on me.
Yeah.
Or to miss.
So it helps. Anyways, I roll 16 and higher.
Yeah. So yeah, just Hawken chairs.
All traps should be disabled by now. I mean, Sol knows the mechanism to.
So. What say we get the fuck out of here?
I'm not a dumb bird.
Well, it's
I'm a pretty smart bird. I'm like a raven, you know?
But are you also like a writing desk?
Edgar.
All right. Let's go. Hurry up.
I can't move. You're gonna be paused.
Yep, so Sol would have.
Why are you guys so slow? Come on. Get your asses moving.
Just put us in front of those doors.
Oh, I'm old. Jeez.
Okay.
Oh. Itis is kicking in.
Okay, here we are.
Oh, shit.
Okay, do you want to go up or right? Do you want to go magical sparkly door or.
I would like to leave and come back at another time to finish clearing out the rest of this area.
Do we just rest down here, or I guess I don't know. You guys have tents and stuff.
Yeah, do you want to just find a good spot to board up and go in the torture chamber?
If we're going to rest, we might as well go up top. I mean, the stairs are just to the south of us. We got stairs like right here.
I can't see anything, man.
Sure,
Like straight down this hallway, there are some stairs that lead up.
All right.
Okay.
Maybe you could sleep with the kobolds. Well, that didn't sound right, but whatever.
Yeah, I wouldn't mind getting my wits back about me.
Wee.
All right.
Yes,
so
I would
let's
like
just
to fast track
this here.
Oh.
I would like to put my kidneys back inside of my body, if that is acceptable to the rest of you.
That's where they.
Oh,
belong.
It's so dark. Nah, man, you took the light with you, our Sherman.
Yes, I did.
All right. So anyway, I'm moving you guys back to the stairs here.
Walk this way.
So, what's all happening here? Like, you guys just to go back to the camp, or you chill with the kobolds at rest, or
Probably could just chill with the kobolds if they're cool with it.
We did save them from the.
Yeah, they want to hang out.
You two saved them from the.
We
creature.
Could all hang out and talk about, I don't know, kobold stuff. I don't know. What do kobolds do?
Go hang out with
for adventurers.
Pib and Zarf.
Maybe they can teach me a traditional kobold dance. I'd like to see that.
Pib. And Zarf and Steve.
And Zarf.
Yeah.
I love Zarf. He is my boy.
Well, we're down a kobold boy. Maybe we take Zarf with us.
If anyone would have put Zarf in any danger, I would destroy them with every iota of my not inconsiderable talents. Let us take time to patch ourselves up.
All right, yeah, you take some time to rest and hang out with the kobolds.
Yes, I love the kobolds. I love them.
I think I'm just gonna have Jeb's quiescent state, at least for tonight, be that he just sleeps as a pile of bones.
So right now it looks like it is only about 7, almost 8 o'clock. Can we say that
gonna work
take
on
a couple of hours
or something?
To if we want to like take a couple of hours before we actually rest, could we have Jeb or Namiad or whoever roll a couple of medicine checks to bring me back up before I rest?
Yeah, you guys got time to do that. It's not a problem. No problem.
Would you be willing to roll a couple of medicine checks for me there, Nathan?
Yeah, sure, sure. And if we're, yeah, I'll just go ahead and...
You want a medicine check from the bird?
Yeah.
I can heal.
Yeah, all around, well... Yeah.
No, you can't roll over a 5.
That'll do it.
There you go. I'm not very good
at that. Oh, that wasn't a roll. That's critical success. Okay. That'll do.
I didn't know Namiad was an expert in medicine. You got 2 medicine.
You got nothing
experts.
From the bird. Yeah, I do what I can.
So there you get 17
well, that's like
there.
That's 1 hour right there.
They patched you up nicely. And
yeah. So you're all good? I can't see anyone.
Yeah, you're still back. Your token's still back down at the second floor here.
Oh, you can't
What's Sherman
just have,
went
like,
up?
Token?
So did the light. Spell that he
Sherman's
cast,
up to 28.
So you can't have the tokens on the different map. Like you can't have like everyone's token on one map and then you switch the scene.
You can do that. Oh, it's just I have it set up for stairs, and so
makes it easier.
Going on a certain square will teleport your token to the other scene, and then you're on that scene. Then so, yeah, I'm not gonna go the moving people immediately back. So we're just gonna kind of do theater of the mind until you guys are back here. So,
sure.
Yeah.
So
you're just 2 spaces below.
Are
okay.
My medicine checks are in the perfect spot where I have to roll a 10 or higher, you know, to heal someone. And, in my mind, Soul has just seen people patch him up enough that he kinda knows what he's doing. So maybe sometimes he can help. Because it's like a 50-50 chance what he does would actually help.
Do you guys hunker down, get some rest, and you guys sleep like with the kobolds themselves, or are you going to go to a different room within the upper floor there? You did have that back building there. It was bunch of books and a bit more comfortable perhaps in the stone floor, or you guys could chill here too.
Well, it did seem like it was just that last hallway that we had to clear out down there, as far as I could tell. So I suppose back to the old grindstone. What say you, gentlemen?
Or are we? Right. Yeah, yeah, yep.
What's all the stuff floating around you?
Oh, does wounded get? Do I lose that after a rest?
Yeah, if you're full health and rest, you should be good.
I didn't actually make it back up to full health.
You didn't.
I got another 8 for you.
Then yes.
You guys would have had time to get you to full health. Like you could just be at full health and no longer wounded. So.
Okay, I will go ahead and get rid of that.
Yeah, because unless there's like a time mechanic or random monster table, it's like, yeah, we could do all the rolls and take like 10 minutes to resolve the rolls, or we could just...
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Because it's not like you're going to die. I mean, I guess you could...
Mm-hmm.
Well, I mean, I did almost.
No, for medicine checks. I mean, you're not going to die from medicine.
I suppose if you roll a lot of nat ones in a row.
You could roll like 5 nat ones in a row or something, but...
That's true.
Anyway.
I can't stop stabbing this man with my scalpel.
And so the kobolds actually serve up some breakfast for you guys. You get frogs and some swamp grass. These are omnivorous kobolds, and so you get some delectable swampy foods there. Some fish. They have been catching
fish. Yes.
So I'm guessing you probably opt for the fish.
Yes.
I
do believe I probably...
Hey, you gotta try the swamp grass. It ain't half bad.
I probably tried one of the frogs, and yeah, like I said, it just... delicious. Thank you.
Pip comes over to you and says, I don't really like the swamp grass either. It's okay.
Well, I do appreciate that. What? Ooh. That is some fortifying food, though. I feel like I'm ready to take on the day. What say we, gentlemen?
Rob, they're fun if you just really slurp them up, just like that.
Okay.
Tom loves this.
I have had frogs as cuisine before, but it was mostly just the legs. The rest of the it's fine. Possibly, if I can find the recipe, I will bring it to you at some point.
Well, that'd be great.
Okay. Well, what say we, bud?
Yeah.
All right.
Food is food, man. I mean, I'll eat whatever.
Dude, look at me. I'm a fancy bud with my fancy beak, and I'll shove anything in there.
It's not picky.
What's
this?
The light returns.
Yeah, without having those biological needs, he doesn't get like the satisfaction and, you know, relief and pleasure of, you know, meeting a body's needs. So, you know, feeling full or going to the bathroom or getting a good night's, he doesn't really get any. So that experience is, it's gone forever.
It's lost on him.
It is. And he would miss it. He would miss it.
Right. Oh, I should probably make our. So what time are you guys heading back down here?
Probably pretty early. Would probably say pretty early, like as early as we could.
Like 6 a.m., 7 a.m.?
Yeah, like 6, I think, because we would have gone to bed at around 10, so 6 sounds about
early
right.
Early risers, all
early
right.
Early bird gets the worm.
Yeah. If Jeff had right, a lawnmower, so he would be mowing a lawn.
Here are all of the doors that you have yet to explore here. There's one here. There's one here. And there's some here to the south. Two
I
doors.
Don't actually know if I'm supposed to see this or if this got revealed to me accidentally. Did we ever explore this room down here? Because that looks like some shit.
Which one?
Like kind of that blackened area to the south west.
Okay, I wasn't supposed to see that. I apologize. That's why I didn't say what was actually.
I saw
in
that
there.
A long time ago. I said something about it.
So we have to go check that too eventually.
Yes.
I thought we went in there.
No, I don't think we did. I think
I'm viewing your camera, and I don't. I don't see what you're talking about. Oh, it's like in here.
In,
there's a, it's got the
yeah,
compass
it's
thing, yeah.
Got like a what looks like a transmutation circle on the floor.
Oh, that one.
Yeah.
Yeah, that was an oops, I think.
No worries, but yeah, I just figured that we should go through there at some point. But yes.
I thought we did.
We'll get around to it. Let's just do these ones that were next to.
All right. Let's do this, gentlemen.
Up to the top here.
Pitter patter, get at her.
Pitter patter, let's get at her. I'll hang back here if you don't mind.
All right, so Soul's gonna pop it open.
Do you guys want me to open which door?
No,
am I
feeling a little more right confident. He's only slightly hungover at this point. It's still hanging on there a little bit. Not quite, but 24 hours yet. We'll get there eventually.
His ties on correctly today. The winds are not.
It would be if you helped him out with it.
Yeah, that would help.
Which door? Are we going through? This one?
The sparkly, glowy one, or the one to the right?
Guys,
I say we go through the one up north here.
Okay. Sparkly, glowy, open.
Okay. Let me tell you what you see. This is a washroom. There's an iron bathing tub to the north and a commode to the southwest.
A toilet. Well, not exactly a toilet. More like just a hole in the ground.
Yes. The northern wall glimmers and shimmers with rippling ribbons of eerie green light.
Can I make an arcana check to see what's going on in there?
Tell me what you see, wizard.
Can I cast Detect Magic?
It seems to be...
Bathroom.
Well, let me have Namiad roll here. He's got something a bit more specific for this. Well, I'll say unspecific.
The evil toilet. We have yet to fight an evil toilet.
Let's see here.
I'd shoot we'll
do
an
this
evil
one.
You haven't.
Oh, damn.
You know what I've had to fight to get over here?
Probably a lot, because you're like 8 continents away from where you're...
Yeah, well, Namiad doesn't know shit today. It's like...
I took public transport. Yeah.
I walked along the ocean at some point. Just because I can't...
But yeah, as you guys open that...
I'd shoot an evil toilet.
...door and spend some time kind of observing it, and... you kind of see the ghostly energies within kind of start to want to swirl around a bit. And then letters begin to appear on the wall in a green ribbon of light. And it says, I
buy Pepsi
was Otari. Save me from below.
Okay. where is you at, man? I can't see you.
As you look at the map here, you can see like the spectral light as it was on the wall, kind of begin to slide off the wall.
Oh shit. Oh no, it's coming for us.
And it slides right underneath your legs. It's kind of slithering. Over off to the west.
Okay.
Come on, Scooby-Doo and the gang. Let's follow
this
thing.
Hold on a sec while I get the stream set up here. I gotta get it off and directed so it follows you guys for me, I hope. I'll take Namiad off of the directed view here. There we go. Hopefully the camera just follows you guys. Anyway, yeah, it just kind of whirls around the room here.
Oh, dude, it's that guy we killed.
Okay. No, there it goes. Ah!
It's
way down south.
After. Can't let him get away.
Hello, gentlemen.
And at that moment, it goes right into the wall there.
Well, I can't go there.
Into the
man.
Wall. Where did it go into the wall?
Right where Sol is standing.
Can I make a perception check to see if maybe there's like a hidden door here?
Yeah, perception.
Can I accidentally touch a button and open it?
That's about right.
I mean, you guys are... You saw it go right in there. Oh, sorry, not where Sol is. It's where Sherman is. And yeah.
Sherman is.
You did find...
Mm.
Oh, good, good.
A door there.
Hooray!
Another secret door.
And there are more stairs leading down.
God damn it. Oh. Well, should we go down now or to follow this thing? Or should we clear out the rest?
It seems like a time-sensitive thing. I don't know.
All right, let's do this, gentlemen. I follow down.
Namiad says, wait, guys, weren't we supposed to, like, find some people?
Wait.
Maybe
which
they're
people?
Down here.
They might be down there. There's 3 thieves still missing. Remember, Yin Yasmer.
Oh, yeah. Yes, so I will go back up.
And we're still looking
for
them.
Well, the thing is, we don't know if they're not down there or not. We don't have any intel other than that they're here somewhere. So, I mean, they could be
down there.
I
mean, we found one of them. It looked like the Morlocks killed him.
Well, let's, let's finish our quest up here. We really should, finish,
you know, it's prudent to finish your plate before going back for seconds, as they say.
Agreed.
Some people say that. Don't at me.
Did you get a little lost there, Sawyer? Oh, there's Sewell. Okay, I see him.
Yeah.
Don't at me.
They're like extremely trustworthy of floating green lights and not of actual people and things that have the ability.
Well, maybe it just wanted us to know about that access to the basement there, which, you know, if that's the case, then it is a very friendly spirit or what have you. I certainly appreciate it.
It did say I was Otari.
I thought Otari was a city.
Well, yeah, but all cities are named after somebody.
Oh, I think the party knows that the founder is.
There's a city named after me.
There's like a man. Yeah, something
like
Otari.
Like George Everwinter.
Except this is George Otari, apparently.
No, it was Vashti. Vashti Otari. He was one of the Rose Guard, and he fell
pretty
down
sure
through,
George,
you know, we're Ulrock, and I just, you know, dug our way down here, whatever.
Jonathan Fargo.
Gregory Swordcoast.
He was battling.
I remember being George Otari.
He was battling, so he kind of goes out and tells you, like, the lore, I guess, as what Rin had also had explained to you before. He would remember. The, was a fight between the Rose Guard and Belcora. No, Otari was one of the Rose Guard. The Rose Guard were battling her, and then that place where all the rocks were, right by where the Mitflits kind of were hanging out and were digging around for toads or whatever, that was where there was a big blast, a bunch of rubble had fallen, and Otari was deep underneath that, and so
and Otari was left for dead. Oh, I was kind of hoping he died on the shitter here. Yeah, because his soul was in the bathroom, but if his corpse is up there, I mean, I kind of wish he died on the pot.
Okay.
I guess not.
Well, so, no. We do have another door here that we can go through. Should we clear this out?
Here's your
open her
resident
up.
Door bird. I got this.
Hurry the hell up.
Boop.
You find another door. Another.
Oh, what kind of a bastard would put a hallway in a door here?
Wait. Somebody with better perception than me, look at this hallway.
Okay. Jeb has great perception. Visual acuity, anyway.
Let's see if he can roll anything decent today.
There's my second decent roll of the day.
26, all right.
Yeah.
And 16, all right. It's a normal-ass hallway.
No satanry.
No traps.
Foot. No satanry, no ghost... Hurry, no trappery, from what you can tell.
But I'm the one who has to walk through it, so it's your guys'
oh,
just
hey,
check.
There is one thing that I would like to do.
Should have that be a secret GM rules.
There is one other thing I would like to do while I'm standing here, actually.
Yeah.
Well, there's a number of them.
Can I throw another plank of wood? Can I throw a plank of wood down this hallway to see if these traps have reset?
Oh, yeah. You hear a...
Wow, those traps reset quickly. But, all right, well, let's just not go down that hallway.
Agreed.
A bunch of smoke just rolls.
Here's my question. Does this tight. One go off? Does
oh, the one
the,
that you
does
had
the
disarmed.
Go off? Okay, that one is disarmed. Okay.
Oh, okay.
And let's see here.
Now
it...
It says quickly deactivate the model of the gauntlet before it triggers. Each trap resets automatically after blah 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 blah.
So it did reset, or okay?
Yeah,
I would think
they do reset. I think it's like an hour.
The disabled one.
It's like an hour.
Yeah. The one that chained disabled.
Except for the one that I disabled, possibly.
Oh, okay. Except for that one. Okay. An evil hallway.
Or maybe it's
it says reset automatically after time.
Yeah, that's fine.
Okay. Well, then maybe that one did go off. Okay. Well, let's say we.
I'll say it did.
push forward, gentlemen.
All right. I'm walking through hallway. Ow.
Okay. Nobby's right behind you. Doorway. Number two.
Door. I'm just gonna kick it open.
You found a cleaning closet. Shelves line the walls of this room, each lined with tools used for cleaning or repair work. A silver-headed cane lies amid a tangle of mops, brooms.
Oh, you can be like Knox. Get your pimp cane going on there.
A silver-headed cane.
A silver-headed cane?
Ooh.
What? What is this? I want to see it.
Can I make a...
Oh, it would go perfect with Sherman's fan art there, token there.
It looks definitely like... would.
Yeah, maybe he should have it.
Can I...
I just want to see what it is.
Well, yeah.
Can I... Okay. I don't trust the fact that it's just sitting out in the open like this.
I'll pick it up.
Okay.
Yeah. And here's the thing. This is the weirdest thing. Everything is clean and in good condition.
Oh, everything in here or the
in this room?
Huh. Yeah, I don't.
That seems to be the most valuable thing. Is this the cane?
Okay.
Are there any more doors? I can only see like a part of the.
Well, I picked it up. Does anything happen to me?
Treasure sitting out.
Here's what happens. Some things will, like, it was kind of propping up some things on a shelf, and then some things fell off the shelf, and there was a bit of a clatter, but that's really all that happened.
Junk-a-lanch.
Well, Soul's not very graceful, so grabbing it, and, he's
so,
just like...
Yeah, just...
I probably just grabbed it, started walking back towards you guys to show it to you, and it's like falling down behind me.
Yeah.
Oh.
Somebody knocked that over.
Okay. That does look very nice.
Do we notice anything on it? Anything noticeable on the cane itself? Anything?
Yeah. Can I
roll some checks?
Do I detect any magic?
Perception. No magic. There's no magic.
Perception. 17.
11.
So Soul, you've been around weapons for a good long while, and a bit of an expert about this kind of thing, I guess.
I can roll a weapon.
This is not just any cane. You kind of find a place to, like, kind of hit a button, and then.
Is
a hidden blade inside. Rapier-like sword. So it's a sword cane. A silver sword cane. Low grade.
Interesting.
It's like
our
4th rapier.
What does low grade mean?
Less expensive.
It sucks, bro.
It's relating to the precious material used to make it. So there's certain mechanical effects.
Okay.
Can you level it
up?
Yeah, there's low grade, standard grade, high grade. This one's a low grade one.
Like,
so
does that have any like mechanical stuff as far as like attacking things that are weak to silver?
Yeah, it's silver. So yeah. Definitely.
I think it's in general, its benefits increase with the higher the grade of the silver. So it's like how the silver is refined or whatever. But
interesting. Yeah, okay. So. See, that's what I was talking about. Is like, do you get like a +1 for like low grade or a +2 for high grade silver?
There's a whole thing.
It'll
about
cut
it.
Through damage reduction. If there are things that have damage reduction or if like resistances, or So very useful. I do remember, like, when you had that fight against that devil in that one, like, jail cell room. Silver worked really well against him. So this might come in handy later.
My question then is, would you prefer me to have it, or would you
like to hold on to it, being as proficient as you are in dispatching enemies with in melee, especially with silver. Silver may be more potent in your silver weapon may be more potent in your hands. I personally do love the aesthetic of this weapon and would love to hold on to it, but
well, let's think about this.
You what have a number bonus of silver. Would you get?
What kind of bonus do you get on a like a melee weapon?
It is a finesse kind of weapon.
Yeah.
I so would you can get use a
dexterity with it.
You can use dex.
Can you put it in my inventory real quick?
It's in there now.
Oh, it is in there now. So mm-hmm. I should have it. Silver sword cane. Oh, I can't attack with it.
Ha. Because you suck.
I also can't. Oh, I may have to go in and actually equip like, it. There we go.
Yeah, probably.
So, something yep. Like that. Held one hand. There we go. So, silver sword cane, I get a +9 to hit with that. I could put a +1 rune on there. I would get a +10 to hit.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So is there anything else left in the closet, or are we good to go?
If you need a broom or that kind of thing.
Pass.
Now's your chance.
Pass.
So what kind of attack do you get on that?
I would get a +9 if you want it.
That's pretty good.
It's not bad. The other thing that I can do with that is I may be able to. I have a +1 rapier. I could probably move that +1 over to the silver sword cane at a later time.
Mm-hmm. Sounds good.
Yeah, I probably have a +10. Right?
Or yeah, that would give me up to a plus. That would give me a +10.
Well, that's what I'm saying. How it is now, I think I get maybe 2 more than you. So. It's not much different.
Okay. Yeah, we'll call it good.
You can have a sword. That's cool. Like, it fits your aesthetic. And I'm running out of bulk.
Your bulks, yeah.
Fair all enough.
Stuff. Yeah,
you're just strapped to the tits with weapons.
Arm, yeah, head to toe.
And I can't. Yeah, I would like to go home at some point to get rid of some of this stuff.
Fair.
Me.
He carries the retribution axe in his beak.
The retribution axe is too bulk, dude. Yeah. This thing is heavy.
That's like Zoggle's old weapon, the maul. His was 4 bulk. His was 4 bulk.
I got healing potions for days. They're 2 L's. I don't know what an L is, but I got
10
two.
L's make 1 bulk. That's the system. Yeah.
Okay. Well, yeah. Let's should we clear out this? It looks like there's a couple more doors in here. Should we
one to the north? Oh,
in the
broom south?
Closet?
Yep.
Half plate, by the way. 3 bulk.
Oh yeah.
Ooh boy.
You guys should buy a bag of holding.
It definitely there's wouldn't a belt. Hurt.
There's also a belt that increases your bulk. Something ant belt or something, or maybe I'm thinking of a different edition.
Technically, we are not a high enough level to buy a bag of holding yet.
Bummer, dude.
It's fine.
It is a level 4 weapon.
You do have level a place 4 magic to item. Dump your stuff.
Yeah.
Okay. So let's go on to the next. So, where would it's up to you. Which door would you like to
up or down? Left or right, guys? Left or right? Where are we going?
It's up to you, my good sir.
I can't see what you guys are saying. So
if you'd like to move in closer.
Up sure. Up a coin. Is it slash R?
Fuck, I'm just going to go up.
Heads left.
Okay, you're going to roll for it.
Boom.
Heads left.
All right.
So here's what you see when you pop that door open. You see a creature that seems to be part...
What?
I don't know. Some kind of like bug man. Here's what he looks like. I'll put him up here on the screen so that everyone can see.
Guy.
Oh, yes.
Kill it with fire, I think is what...
Soul would have been very loud this whole time when he's talking to you guys.
Yeah, he's got wings and he's got a long tongue.
Close it. don't want to see that.
And yeah, a big old thorax with a bunch of legs, and then some type of humanoid parts to him as well.
Like, and so,
yes, he seems to have stayed there waiting for you. And at that moment, he lurches forward and attacks you guys, saying, oh, let's see, what did he say?
I'm immune to bugs because I'm a bird.
He eats them. One bite.
Intruders! I will destroy you all! And we'll see you next week.
I'm gonna eat this.
Oh, by the way,
dude, I'm gonna eat this.
One other thing happens. You level up.
Oh, hey!
Oh, goddamn!
Hey-o.
Yep. Those traps earlier gave you just enough to bump you up to level six, or give you 60 points to get you up there. So, thanks for watching, everyone, and have a great night. We'll see you next week.
Woo-hoo! All right. I will have.